And
Jackie.
let's continue. So, John.
Ow.
Meanwhile, Satan, what are you looking for? A lighter?
No, no, he's had enough. I'm roleplaying a drunk bastard.
Actually,
he's had enough. He's going
Satan
out to town.
Running, I'll walk away. Because I don't kind of care about Alexander.
You walk away from the guy who, from all you know, was trying to set fire to the house and has gone and apparently incapacitated your ductus.
I don't give a
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, to remember, your Auspex said that John was about to kill the rest of the party.
No, he was going to unleash demonic powers.
No,
oh,
he
yeah,
said
it was,
kill.
It was no wait. Was it demonic powers? I don't remember that part.
Demonic
very
powers
well.
And unleash hellfire on everyone. I do believe.
Yes, I remember the hellfire part. You're right.
The hellfire part, I do remember as well.
If you turn your back on him, you will be burned to ash. You must act now or never have a chance. Let me just roll willpower for one of the other packs to see how well they resist something they might or might not have discovered.
I'm very injured, so I'm gonna run.
John, you just see Anton run like a little bitch.
I can't blame him. I once ran. So, yeah. He will just grab the lighter and throw out of the window.
It's
there
already
no
broken,
windows
piece
nearby.
Of shit. It's not going to go anywhere.
I'm going to look for Satan.
I go to the closest window and throw the lighter.
Okay. In unrelated news, the demon was rolling at difficulty 9, the pack at 6. You will happily see that none of them managed to properly resist.
Yeah, 5 successes is kind of hard when your max is 5, guys. Just putting that out there.
Well, to be fair, it was a 9 difficulty.
Yeah, there's that too.
I think
in fact,
whatever.
It was a 9 plus 3, if I remember right. But
not if it's actually on this plane and they walk close enough to its physical presence, essentially coming into its lair.
Alright, good to know. So, Satan's off for a night in town as someone else.
Okay.
With no blood, so prepare to frenzy.
That was the idea, yeah.
Okay. I like this. I like this a lot. Roll, charisma, empathy.
Okay.
Okay, there are 5 thin bloods running around town now. As you have a wonderful party.
Yay, wonderful party.
Should be 5-10 bloods. Well, you want chaos anyway, right?
And actually, this could end up fairly decent for me anyway. How much blood do I get?
You're very much full.
Yay. And I presume that most of the night has gone by this point.
By the time you're done draining the hunter chick who you met earlier and showing her how glorious something called night can be when you take a full dose.
Yes,
it is. Alexander, you are on the floor. You just see Anton walking away through the haze of pain. John,
and
what would you like to do?
He will
what can
Alexander.
I do? I'm at incapacitated. I'm not supposed to be able to do anything.
You're not. You can just croak out a word or two at most.
John,
to what?
Will take
the guy that just incapacitated me?
Yeah,
so he can kill me?
He could try to get my attention.
With
it's
what?
Too late. You just turned the corner.
Help me. Yeah, don't give me 2 Auspex in here, any of that.
John will just take Alexander, carry him to the kitchen remove the gasoline out of his body with water, and then tie him up and throw him on the library.
Okay.
What did you remove?
Essentially, he strips you naked and spends an hour and a half giving you a sponge bath.
I don't want him to burn himself and destroy the mansion.
Okay. About 2 hours later, Anton, you see John carry in the fucked up Tremere into the library and dump him on a table for you to play with.
I was so beautiful once.
He mutters in his delirium.
John leaves the place, look at Anton and say, later I want you to make me a better face. It's a little bit scarier and prettier, please. And just go to clean the gasoline up on the room.
I'm still awake.
How does Anton react to this?
Smash face at the floor?
Not for long. Duck. Still awake? Duck.
Tell me what happened.
He is unlikely to be able to form coherent speech right now. One or two words and a croak is the best he can manage.
And I think you're fairly convinced that John is worshipping demons right now. And that's a couple hours pass by.
Listen.
Then you go back. Maybe then you can talk. I don't know.
We need to deal with John. Don't have any blood on me. I have my blood.
Well, actually, you had to be thigh infusions.
No. But I thought only I could use those.
Yes, yes.
But he has his own. Where's your Vitae infusions?
Yes, you can drink them at any time.
Can you point to where he keeps them?
Have them. I gave multiple ones to you.
Yeah, but I can only use my own, I thought.
You can, yes, on a mental command from you, they turn back into blood.
Okay, so I'm going to give him 5 points.
Why would you give me 5 points? You give yourself 5 points.
Still 5 points.
Like you said, you just said you had no blood.
No, I have no blood to give you to heal you up.
Yes, and I'm awake. Apparently, there's no need to do that.
Alexander, he assumes that you are out of blood and just starts shoving Vita infusions into your mouth and you feel blood just pouring down the back of your throat.
I'm not activating the Vita infusions.
He activates them because they're bound to him. You don't get a choice in the matter. He just shoves them in your mouth.
I'm nearly full of blood.
Am I still Gen 8 for this?
Is there anything I can do about, like, aggravated damage with my abilities?
No.
Would you like to try?
God, I would.
Of course you would. You're a cunt like that, aren't you?
What did you laugh at him doing?
He's gonna try and heal your aggravated with this dude. You are still in Gen 8. Please add that up temporarily. And
With the ritual we did earlier, is it possible that I can give him my blood and not like blood bind him or shatter the?
No, you're not blood binding me because we have a vinculum.
Yes.
Which means that temporarily you might feel a bit of a thing, but the vinculum will, as we keep doing it, wash it away.
Awesome.
To give him your
blood?
Because
that's how the vinculum works.
I need a decision here. You just feed him the Vita infusions?
I'm still trying to figure out what I'm going to do. It wouldn't help any because he's got aggravated damage. I wasn't taking that into consideration earlier.
Here's the thing, Anton. You haven't tried to heal aggravated damage before with this dude. You might be curious, and when in doubt, just go with what your character does and does not know. You have no idea what you can and can't do in terms of aggravated damage.
Does he have any occult?
Can I roll for it?
Not if you don't have any occult.
I do have occult.
You do. In that case, sure. Give me an intelligence occult.
There's a library around you if you want to do something with that.
Shall we if you want to seven? Research the rest of the night.
We shall say seven.
Difficulty seven.
Does he actually, did he ever, what? How many points does he have?
Like two. And it's strangely specific, because vicissitude versus aggravated wounds if he hasn't experimented personally.
That feels like a nine to me, I'll be honest.
Yeah? Huh.
That's a really specific question for something that's not even that well known. Even among people of his...
Well, I would even get one. I would get one success on it and think that might not be a good idea. Especially since it's the Ductus.
You wouldn't know, honestly, but you're pretty... Well, you know that vicissitude is more about modifying the actual normal state of body rather than repairing it up to that normal state. That being said, you could theoretically heal some of his aggravated wounds, you're pretty sure. It would just be difficult as fuck.
Oh, I can't do anything to help you.
Then
sorry, man.
Put me in my pet.
Sure. Where is your bed?
You probably have seen it if you're seen a room on the side.
Actually, we've been very specific. Anton does not know where your hidden place is.
Yes, that's true. Telling you something
actually,
about
dirt. You do know that essentially he keeps his dirt just in his library, and Anton does know about it because you have been experimenting on Darnell there together.
Oh yeah, they've been doing that together.
In the library?
Yes.
Yes.
I thought we were in the basement area.
Yes, it's in the basement.
Okay, in that case, I take him to his bed.
That's just he calls the bed, but it's just a corner of the library where he curls around a bag of fertilizer from Lithuania for some reason.
Why don't I have a proper bed? There are so many beds around. Why would I not have a proper bed?
Because you don't care about such mortal comforts, and you're better than that, and it doesn't matter to you. You're superior to those
needs. I still care about having a bed.
Well, to be blunt, most vampires
know me. Literally.
You said yourself that you sleep in the library just with your dirt. I just assumed you were on some sort of a table, honestly.
I thought I at least had some bedding there.
Why would you? You're a scholar,
that's
completely
okay.
Disconnected from crap. You just sleep in your clothes on a table, wrapped around a fertilizer bag.
I'm guessing there might be a corner where there's a bunch of books and I just sleep beside them.
That makes some sense.
It's important in character knowledge, Nietzsche. You don't know how important this is. It's
to be fair,
character.
I'm pretty sure Satan's gonna be gone for a couple days here, so
so in this case, storyteller, can you tell me, does he have a bed or does he have a little pit that he sleeps in or a place to curl up in?
There's
a bunch of books, some dirt.
A comfortable little nest because it's some of the bookshelves where there's a bunch of books and a sleeping bag along with the bag of dirt.
Okay, that makes sense. So I take him to his sleeping bag, his sleeping area. Do you want me to make any rolls for that?
Do not drop him and torpor him, you mean?
Sure.
Nah, it's good. You tuck him in.
Hurt on him, and I go, and I just kind of tap him on the face like, yeah, I know how it is.
So, John. Towards the morning, after you're done mopping up the gasoline, what would you like to do? Bacon?
I'm thinking. He would look again at the gazebo to try to understand why the demon was talking about it.
Okay, roll perception investigation. I love the fact that he doesn't know Epic. It isn't over yet. Go ahead and roll for it. Okay. Well, the gazebo looks like it has had a fresh coat of paint. It's practically glistening, looking almost perfect, like the best gazebo you have ever seen. And the mass grave you had dug for your victims has been filled in by someone else, without you realizing it.
You know what's even greater? He doesn't even know as a player.
Yes, I know, right?
I don't know what I missed, but he will check the graves that should have his victims but are full with something.
I mean, the graves and the trench, essentially, it's all been filled in.
You know, this could very well actually be directed at all of this is John's fault. And it doesn't even realize it.
This wouldn't have happened, actually. You're right, if John hadn't just been dumping crap there all along.
Also, I'm guessing everything from the very start that went wrong could be claimed to be John's fault.
Exactly.
Because the Maltavian went to fix your mess.
And I did partly fix the mess, and then it went far worse.
Look, at least this time, I'm not opening portals to demons to invade the world, so it's better.
That is true.
Oh, don't worry. The one taunter you haven't met yet personally is starting to chant in an undisclosed location. It's fine. Well, not yet, but it's coming. You know it is.
So he checked the place, what he sees.
Now that's more or less what you see. You see the awesome gazebo, and overall, it looks like the backyard has had some work done on it. People have come in here, filled in the crap, and just, well, made it look in a way more civilized, but clearly they have been looking at things and touching things they shouldn't have.
He will just go inside, maybe go to the library to try to learn about demons.
Okay.
Or locked.
The door is locked, apparently.
He just knock on the door.
Anatol, you hear someone scrabbling at the outside of the steel door to the library. What do you do?
I just ignore it. I ignore it.
John, there's no response.
Try to lockpick the door.
Okay.
With my claws?
With your claw?
Yes.
Make my dexterity larceny. Roll a difficulty 9 plus 1. And even that is really generous, actually. Even that you're doing it with the fucking claw. Anton, as you're just about used to the soft sounds coming from the door, it slowly swings inwards. You see John stand up, throw a menacing look at you. Or what I you stand interpret up. As a menacing look anyway.
I stand up and gaze at him.
John just ignore him and go to Thief Books and start looking for something that could talk about demons or gazebos.
He's ignoring me like a Borg, so I'm going to carefully examine him. I'm going to read his aura, I think.
Okay.
Awesome when I botch. Oh, God. Oh, God. I only got 2 dice.
Go for it. Don't be a bitch. No balls, no glory. Okay. You see very little, in fact. You see bits of vampire pale covered with thick streaks of black.
Would I know that the black is diablery?
Since you're just starting to use this ability, you'd have to roll perception, or sorry, not perception, but intelligence occult, I think at something like 8.
Yeah,
since
okay,
the books does suggest that this is usually something most elders know, but not necessarily every neonate. Yeah, you're pretty sure that this thing is like a bad thing, that elder vampires, in the Camarilla at least, have been known to kill people over. You just can't seem to quite make the connection with just a marginal success. But this is a bad thing, this black.
He's a demon worshipper. It's been confirmed.
Yes,
would you
absolutely.
Like to roll initiative now? And
definitely.
Take your surprise
kill
round?
Kill the guy that's going to end us all.
No, because he's ignoring me.
You can take a surprise round and strike first.
No, I'm not doing it.
You know he's a demon worshipper.
Anton, roll intelligence occult at difficulty 6 for me, please.
Wow, I never even realized this. That's cool.
What?
I found a thing that recommends on how to build new disciplines.
Huh. Oh, cute. Okay.
You link it?
I have
Where's
seen
that at?
Some of these way, way back. Anton, you realize that he's pulling books of demon lore off the shelves.
Oh my god.
Yeah, this is definitely him being a demon worshipper. Kill him now before he can strike.
This has been an amazing, just an amazing session.
I go
where
open
everything, where everything went exactly as people went, like, yeah. This...
Congratulations, Alexander. I don't hate you as much now. As I walk over to you and stand over your body, prepared to protect it.
So you're not going to act against the guy that's obviously going to attempt to burn the, kill both of us before he can open the gate to hell.
John, this won't. It will take you time to research. You will be researching for the rest of the night, but just to get an idea as to what books you're getting and so on, give me an intelligence occult roll. The base difficulty would be 8, but you would get, I think, 3 extra dice and -2 to difficulty. So roll with a bonus of 3 dice at 6.
I don't think that's how you're supposed to roll, by the way.
Yes, yeah. Re-roll it entirely.
Use an actual rolling macro.
They are there for convenience, so...
It's 7 dice. That's 6. You can do it.
Okay. You pull up information on demons. So, yeah, Anton, you're pretty sure one of those books is a list of demon names, as in with the kind of demon names that you would actually be able to summon. Low-level stuff that a vampire could control. Theoretically. Possibly, for a little bit before they inevitably lost control.
John just asked to Anton, "Hey Anton, what do you know about demons?"
Would you like to learn more? Would you like to learn about our Lord and Savior Ashman?
I know that what you are doing is probably a bad idea.
That's one way to put it.
I suggest, John, since I like you, please do not pursue this sort of knowledge.
But how I am going to fight demons if I don't know about them? I'm pretty sure that the demon want to...
And I have no empathy to check to see if he's lying.
Perception, empathy versus manipulation, subterfuge now.
Oh god.
Because I want to see how well you can tell what his real motivations are.
And can't tell at all.
And John? I would like a... He seems sincere. Clearly he has been instructed in the art of lying.
That's right. Always been a great liar.
Actually, it would have been at 6, but it's the same difference, so who gives a fuck? Just stare at each other awkwardly.
But seriously, the demon tried to get in my head. I make it get off, but Alexander was talking with him. The Malkavian said that Alexander went burned the place.
Okay. John? Could you leave me in the ductus for a moment, please?
He just admitted to talking to a demon. Didn't he, Anton?
Yes, he did. Can you leave me to the ductus right quick?
Alright. Just take the books. Be careful. He was hostile, trying to burn everything.
Okay, sure.
And just leave the place.
Close the door behind you.
He closes the door.
You got one success on the opening of the lock, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. John closes the door and walks off. And when you see the door close, there's a click, and then it slowly swings open just a crack. Apparently he has ruined the lock with his claws.
Oh, God. Ductus. He just admitted to it. How can I get in touch with Satan, the priest? Not the real Satan.
You don't even sure he is. He isn't the real Satan.
That is true. You never know.
So
I'm gonna say that Lynn, however you want to pronounce it, has given you a phone number to report on the goings on in this pack. So you could tell him, because they would care, probably, about this happening.
Yeah. They are totally not demon worshippers.
You don't know that it was their pack that met a Earthbound somewhere.
Okay, oh for the gosh, good...
That'd be amazing.
For the good... of the Sabbat, I give my life... fighting this menace that could be worse than anything we've ever dealt with.
Don't worry, I'm bringing accidental reinforcements.
I'm going to call Lynn.
Those people, they are essentially, you tell them that you're gonna give them some night, you turn them, and then you leave them. You don't stay around. You're gonna wake up next to the chick that was able to see you through obfuscate, but that's it.
Yeah. I was going to see about tracking them down and over the next couple of nights, basically train them as,
shovelheads.
You know, yeah. Train them as real shovelheads with a little bit better stuff going down. But actual shovelheads.
Okay, you call Lynn. Anton, is that you? Do you have something to report?
Yes. It's been good. I'm probably going to die now because John, one of our pack mates, appears to be an infernalist, and I'm about to go attempt to put him down. So if I'm unsuccessful, please kill him for me. Thanks.
Click. There's a stunned silence from the other end as you hang up, if that's what you're doing.
I go upstairs and I say, "What's up, John?"
Do you buff as you go?
Yeah, I will.
Yes, you do.
You can buff as far as you want. You have enough time to spend as
well,
much
so you can,
as you wish.
You can drink your Vitae infusions while buffing.
That's true. You can use all your resources. You have loads. You can buff your
strength
to 10.
You have like 8
10.
Of them right now?
You can
or
buff
7?
Your strength
buff
to
my
10.
Strength. Hold on a second. Let me see something.
You can buff your strength to 10 just before trying to bonecraft him. It is a thing.
That's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use all my Vitae infusion to buff my strength.
Okay.
Well, hold on. Yeah, it'd pretty much be 6, so I'd be left with 1 left. But I'm going to go ahead and use that.
Okay.
So.
You have a 7. You have at least 7 Vitae infusions.
I have 7, so I can buff my strength to 6, and then I'm going to go up 1 point in blood, because I wasn't full. Oh, wait, it's next night, so that doesn't go up.
It's not the next night yet.
It's not?
Yeah, this is
so
the very morning, like 20 minutes from dawn.
Okay.
So, John is studying in the kitchen. Anton walks in and says hi. Anton, I want a manipulation subterfuge from you and a perception empathy from John. To see if he can see the murder in your eye.
To be fair, you're apparently leaking your killing intent.
And Anton?
Yeah, he's planning something.
Oh. That, I see. John, there's something off about Anton. You're not entirely sure what, but he seems really focused on you for some reason all of a sudden.
Can I roll to remember how Alexander power works?
Which power? Alexander's?
Yeah, the presence one.
You can roll intelligence occult if you wish. Anton, what do you do as he is... as I'm going to assume he stands up and goes deep into thought. Okay, you know how presence works. It essentially can make someone more likable or scare them off.
Can I rush over to him and bonecraft his chest while he's thinking?
I would say you would be able to do that, yes.
That's what I think
John,
I need to
do.
John,
you know that that presence can make someone fall in love with them. You haven't seen Alexander do it yet. But you know
probably,
that this is a thing.
Probably he did to Anton, and Anton is helping his lover to release the demons.
So... Anton, meanwhile, as you realize this about presence, you see that Anton is in your face and is launching his hands and trying to sink them into your chest.
Difficulty 8.
I think it's 7 for Bonecraft.
The heck? No, that's not right.
Yes, it is.
That's not right at all.
Yes, it is.
Roll again.
No, it's not. It's 14, but it didn't go 14.
You are buff to 10 strength, I believe, right?
Oh, so yeah. Are you spending willpower to ignore wound penalties?
No, he's not, I believe.
No. Because I got 14. This is medicine strength, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. So then I got 12 done.
I think he actually has a little more than 12. Yes, you just rolled 5 ones. Be happy. Be happy you got a success.
What are you trying to do? This is not aggravated. Use your both your stamina and fortitude to solve this.
It's not the graphic.
He doesn't have fortitude.
He does. He bought it with his freebie points, I believe, at the start.
What? Sorry?
That's not how you do it.
Sorry again. I pressed dot instead of 6.
Still not how you do it. Okay, that's better.
So you soak it, your hands just slide across his chest without seemingly being able to find purchase. Anton, make sure to subtract a point of blood for that. You have one turn of strength at 10 left, and then you need to essentially... It lasts for 3 rounds. You would have spent one of them just walking in, getting close to him. Namely saying hi, one on this attack, and you have one left, at which point you need to spend at least one blood point just maintaining it. Otherwise it wears off immediately. Down to 6, that is.
I'm down to 6 blood points?
No.
Not yet!
Okay.
I'm talking about strength.
Okay.
Right? Like, strength, if you don't spend a blood point on strength next turn, then after that turn, it will go down to 6 strength. Because if you go past 6, it wears off really quickly, essentially.
Yeah.
Okay? So on your next turn, what would you like to do? As you can see that John is about to eviscerate you.
I'm going to die, but I'm going to bonecraft his chest if I survive this next onslaught of attack.
Okay. John, what would you like to do as he's about to do whatever he tried to do again?
I think that he will use his... Oh, he doesn't have his claws out. That's a problem.
You can always grow him.
You spend a turn growing them. In that case.
Can I grow them and try to dodge at the same time?
Let's go double check. Let's see, that is from
Celerity?
Protean, I do believe.
Yes, it is Protean.
What was it, Primal Claws? No?
Grow from both hands and... It's Feral Claws. Second
yes,
part.
Feral.
Requires expenditure of blood point and takes a single turn to complete and lasts for a scene.
So essentially it's like a concentration thing. It doesn't require a roll, but it does...
I will use my celerity.
Don't they grow automatically in response?
It says grow automatically in response to the character's desire and can grow from both hands and feet.
Oh, so it's instantaneous.
It's not instantaneous. It will take a turn for him to actually grow, but it is response to your desire for having the claws, basically.
So you can take a normal action, but you can grow the claws and take celerity actions at the same time, and even if you had enough blood, the claws wouldn't be grown until next turn.
Right.
So I can dodge
you can't actually spend more than one blood per turn because you're not at correct generation for that.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Exception to celerity.
He will try to grow and the claws while dodging.
Okay. In that case, I need Anton to make me a dex brawl to actually hit him, and John make a dex athletics to dodge. Keep in mind your celerity dice, since you're not using celerity actions, do add this. Wow.
You can get one success, right?
God, all these dice.
He has to fail. Yeah. you're pretty sure that he was there, but not entirely. As he moves to the side and just casually sidesteps, claws sprouting from his fingers with a, "Oh, you didn't, you bitch," look on his face.
Now, so who rolled what?
What is your Valdry rating to Anton, John?
8.
So you are unlikely to try to kill him, and you are pretty sure that he's not in his right mind and needs to be saved from himself.
Yeah. You know also that he's very wounded.
I don't know about that.
You can still see the previous claw marks on his face. You know.
An injured tail, you know.
So he will take it easy and don't use alert actions to claw him to death.
Anton, that's what do you do easy, on right? the next
I turn? Won't use all my attacks on him, just one that has enough dice in it to kill even an elder.
Yes.
Just one in one turn. In one turn, he could kill me.
Yes, let us proceed with execution. Anton, what do you do on your next turn of life? Oh, did you spend blood to rebuff your strength?
No, he spent it on...
No, I mean Anton. Because he was a...
I just spent 2 points of blood.
Okay, good. Then your strength is still there for another 3 turns. You probably won't need it for that long. So, what is your move here?
To aim at his chest and do the same thing.
You know... You could get creative with it. You could try to strike his hand and try to, I don't know.
Can I block?
Yes, blocking's a thing. But there's one problem.
What's the role for blocking?
Blocking a claw that fucks you up whenever it touches your flesh is not a good idea.
No, but I thought maybe I could block it.
He said that he would block it. Let him block it.
No, I didn't say. I asked if it was. I actually said, if we're going to go with what I said, we'll just go with what I said. Let's go with what I said.
He already said if he was going to fleshcraft.
Mm-hmm. Bonecraft.
You need to have something equipped to your hands, like gauntlets or something, that will let you actually block the strikes.
I would let against, just usual fist strikes, I would let you do it with your bare hands. But
that is actually how it's ruled. It just depends on what they're using to attack you with.
Well, actually, I would say that if you roll at a higher difficulty, like 8, to hit their wrist aside instead of blocking their weapon, then you can do it, but you are essentially rolling higher difficulty to do a fancy block.
Oh, that sounds cool.
I mean, that's what I was going to do, is not make any contact with his claws, but...
With his dice,
I'm just going to state a course and just do what I know best. So let's just go with this, and hopefully I won't die.
Okay.
But John will, because Lynn will kill him.
Okay, so...
Go ahead. Look, everyone can come back. Everyone can come back as my new pack of thin bloods.
Yeah. I refuse to be a thin blood again. Especially my cavian thin blood.
You can be the one guy that is actually a full-blooded 14 gen. Wow, the dice are mean today. Dice angry.
Oh boy, the dice are real angry today.
Go ahead and roll damage. So that's 2 points of damage. So Anton, you still have a chance. If you can eviscerate him on this turn, you win.
Didn't he try to dodge?
No, he didn't. He decided that he was going to go with his origin. He was just contemplating the idea. He didn't actually say he would do it.
So I think he's at like 4 health levels of ag damage.
More, but he's still at -2. He's, I think, at mauled.
Have fun! Oh my, he is having fun.
Only 5? Did you spend willpower on that?
That is true. You'd have...
did now.
Niche?
Yeah.
We haven't been hearing you. I'm going to be generous and assume that it's a technical derp and that you said all the right things at all the right times.
I spent willpower to ignore one penalties.
No, yes, that is lethal. So you take only 2 points. But you also lose half your blood pool, rounded up. As your chest caves in. So, Angar, what would you like to do on the next turn?
You cut out again.
Yes, you did indeed cut out again.
It's messing up again. Okay, so I'm going to state a course and do it again. Thonecraft his chest. Yeah.
Do you wish to do anything else?
A prayer to God, try to recover your lost humanity, go for Golconda before it's too late, beg the gods of dice and GMRE to save your miserable life.
I will be nice and I will try to tackle him.
Okay, going for a grapple.
Yeah.
Oh my.
Anton, would you like to abort to a dodge as he is attempting to...
I can't.
You can roll willpower.
You could roll for it if you wanted.
Difficulty 8. You don't need to spend willpower to abort
still
to
use his, can he still bonecraft him even if he's...
If I dodge, is it possible to grab him as a dodge?
Not really, no.
Why?
Okay.
No,
why would you do that? That would make no sense.
Anymore.
You can counter... I would say that if you abort to a defensive thing, since he's coming right at you, I don't know, I guess you could try to immediately take control of the grapple, just grab him and...
That's just how that would go, I would think. You would just determine it. We just need to know who would control the grapple.
Yes, yes. That would usually just happen on the on his next turn, so John would get one attack. Yeah, no. You really are kind of boned there, aren't you?
What's the difficulty on the willpower roll?
8.
Difficulty.
Why would you? What question?
I actually think
can
it was.
Can he still bonecraft John if he's grappled?
I would say the difficulty would have to go up. I have been meaning to take another look at grapple things because a lot of people say they're meant to be able to attack with fangs and like even if you're not in control of the grapple. But I do think there should be at least a +2 to the difficulty of the attack from the one who isn't in control of the grapple.
Mm-hmm. I don't think that you should be able to try and bite somebody if they're in control of the grapple.
I mean, if they're not actively trying to hold you still. Like, if they're in control of the grapple and they're using their action to hold you still, you're fucked. You're essentially completely immobilized. If they're trying to attack you, then you're just the one who has an advantage.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
I don't think we should change that in the middle of a session, honestly. So we'll go with the usual rules. If you're in control of grapple, you can try to bonecraft him from there, essentially.
But yeah, it is difficulty 6 to go into a defensive action.
You're sure? It has... I mean,
positive!
Like
I've played this out, like, several times, but...
Yeah, I...
282.
I'm damn sure it has been 8 for a lot of stuff I've looked at. It could have been 3rd edition, though, so not entirely sure. But either way...
I'm pretty sure it's actually stayed the same for all of them, but it's never been something I really particularly care about either way.
I'm sure it has been an 8. But okay. 6.
I don't think I got it anyways. I went 2 against his 3, so...
No. That's willpower. You're just aborting to a defensive action.
Oh, you're right. Okay.
You still need to roll to actually defend.
Okay.
Is he dodging, or...?
Yes, what are you trying to do? Describe to me what you're trying to do, and I'm gonna tell you.
I was gonna try and take control of the grapple.
Also, this is the text on hold. At the time, both combatants roll resisted strength brawl actions, the subject remains immobilized, able to take no other action until she rolls more successes than the attacker does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's for holding.
Okay,
attacks while grappled.
If you're holding, not if you're in normal grapple, that's essentially putting someone in a chokehold. So it is a subdivision of the grapple thing, and we have just been treating each grapple like that.
Yeah, and grapple has always just been weird.
Okay.
Grappling is always weird in every single rule set.
Ever since we had Bronson try to tackle a vampire, and we didn't want him to get eviscerated immediately.
Yeah.
So, you are in a grapple niche. John, roll your strength as damage. Good thing you got that hurt. Imagine how much this would suck if you didn't have a steady supply of blood. Oh my fucking god.
Why did you roll... Nietzsche, why'd you roll 3?
Because I am wounded, and I only have 5 in Dexterity Brawl.
Oh, wait, you're dodging?
Dexterity Brawl was trying to take control of the grapple.
It's strength brawl if you're trying to take control.
Oh, well, that changes everything. I think my buffs are still activated for that one.
Yes, yeah, that's why I'm... That's why I was always in this entire point, why is John trying to grapple the guy that's at 10 strength?
It's a good question, yes. But yeah, no, so now he's grappled.
Actually, you would have one less dice than that because you're at -2 penalties now, unless you have something in brawl. Do you?
I did 1 in brawl.
Ah, then it's correct.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that's an equal amount of successes. Which means that it does not land. So you attempt to grab hold of him, Anton, even as he's trying to grab hold of you and just grab his arms and wrestle him down. But somehow the force of impact just makes him fly over you as you're both carried to the ground and you're both prone with him having flown over you. And out of using grapple.
Huh. That was weird.
Hmm.
See, this is why it gets confusing. I'm not sure why Nietzsche even said to go into defensive action, so...
Because with the initiative, the way it's set up, John would get one attack before he could even try to take control. Not that getting clawed is any better.
I thought he would have taken control even on the initial thing.
Like, on initial, the grapple just hits and you're both in a grapple at that point.
Mm-hmm. But someone still has to take control of it. That's always how it's worked.
We have always ruled that the one who initiates it is in control of it until someone can either throw them off or take control of it. That's why they get advantage if they can successfully land it.
Oh. Huh. Okay.
Okay, so what do you want to do, Anton, on your next turn? Keeping in mind, you don't necessarily have to get up to try and grab him and craft him, because he's right next to you. Now, you might be cut out again, because we're not hearing you.
That's why I was asking. I was actually asking if we were on our stomachs or on our backs to know what I could do.
You are on your sides just crawling around right now, trying to shake the fog from your heads from the impact. As far as I'm concerned.
I'm going to try and break his arm. His strong arm. The one he uses the most.
Huh.
Wow, someone got smart.
Okay. Attacking with your rough arm is a plus one to the difficulty of the attacks, I believe, though.
Sure. Whatever you want it to be.
I mean, I'm recalling from the rules, that's why ambidextrous was always a crap merit. Mm-hmm.
That's because it was mainly meant for shooting rather than hitting. But offhand is actually usually plus two, I think, without ambidextrous.
I mean, I don't care. It's going to make his difficulty go up either way.
I mean, he's going to... There's a good chance he'll attack you next turn. I'm not sure you have enough time with your health the way it is. I mean, you might well be in YOLO mode right now. Like Hail Mary kind of crap. Which means that if you're going to go for an arm breaking, just roll at 9 and try to fuse his arms together.
Hmm. The thing is all the ones I'm getting.
I know, but he has been rolling crap too.
Well, how many successes do I need to get his arms to fuse together that way?
I think it's single one in this case.
No, not necessarily.
Oh, it is a plus one difficulty. Hmm.
If you get 3, it's gonna stay that way, essentially. Less than that, and he's gonna be able to pull them apart eventually.
Oh, gosh.
But at the very
least... I lose all my buffs next turn, do I not?
Yes, I believe you do, or something like that. But if you spend another blood point on your next action to rebuff your strength, you're still good. For another 3 turns.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you wish to do?
Yeah, I just did it too. So...
John, you see that he's gonna try and fuck with your flesh. Again, what do you do?
I will bite him.
You are not going to.
You can't bite him.
Oh.
Because he managed to essentially, you know, American football thing, you know, just block you, toss you aside, both went sprawling to the ground as he did it. Sort of. Well, he tried to grab you, but just.
Can I use my claws?
He tried to grab you, and you botched, and he got succeeded, and somehow this ended up in both of you flipping around and going on the floor.
Wait. He botched on strength. He didn't botch on... Yeah. They got an equal amount of successes.
Oh, I didn't see the success part.
Yes.
He already rolled his strength? Okay.
Yeah.
Wait, well, wouldn't that hurt him? If he botched on strength?
No. Never.
It never kicked in because you rolled... Because we assumed that... I assumed that the grapple went through. That's why I called for him to roll strength damage. Because you rolled off the derp first. Remember?
All right. Yeah, I did.
And yes, you would be able to reach him to claw him, because if he's close enough to grab your arms, you sure as hell can slash at his face, kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
All right. He's going to die, probably.
Probably.
You can always spend a willpower point to pull back at the last second.
Just make sure he gets incapacitated instead.
I will try my luck.
Okay.
We'll see how strong the luck is.
We fight way too much, guys.
This is why we can't have nice things. We're always fighting each other.
Kind of is, I'm dead. Am I dead?
John, do you wish to hold back at the last second, or do you not? As you can see, that it's gonna be a solid hit and he's fucked. You're gonna take the top of his head off.
Well, he will have no willpower, but he will try to hold off.
Okay, you deflect your claws slightly, and you peel the skin from the front of his face, exposing the skull and carving a deep gouge out of it as he falls backwards into torpor.
No, John is just bored and doesn't want to do anything. He will just leave the books on the table, go to his room, and stay there for the rest of the time.
So, I hope Alexander had enough blood in his system.
I do, as it happens, have enough blood in my system.
I'm not typing that. John can't eat me.
Actually, I'm more worried about Alexander eating you.
Alexander,
yeah, you definitely shouldn't worry about John eating you.
So, John, you said you were going upstairs with the books and going to sleep.
No, he was going to leave the books. He doesn't want to study anymore. He has no willpower.
Okay, in that case, you go upstairs, abandoning Anton in the room that has windows leading to the back of the house and the graveyard.
Yeah.
At least put him in a cupboard.
It's too late. He said it, I believe.
No, he won't even be able to diabolize him. What is this shit?
So you just gonna leave me in the sunlight?
He has no willpower. He has no willpower. He just
still
Wait. You have a high Invinculum rating, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's up to you, Bacon, then. Do you wish to leave him to die? At this point, it can go either way. What would your character do? And
the high Invinculum rating, but at the same time...
I want you to keep one thing in mind. I want you to ignore the fact that Anton is a player character and treat him as you would any other character in this game. Would you leave him to die?
He's a useful character that can make me look more scary and badass, so... And he has the Vinculum, so he will save him. Just grab him, drop him on the next place that he finds without windows, that no sunlight can go, and just go to his room.
Okay.
Drop in the basement?
No.
Okay. I like this. This is a good thing. This is a very good thing. Alright. So the night passes, and some of you at least wake up the next night.
Well, actually, would I be able to heal?
Not yet, but you will be healed by one point by the next night. So just in time to crawl out and get some blood.
Actually, I have a stuff to spend.
Yes, you do. You do have your Vita infusions, that is true. It's just that... Keep in mind you have gone down one for waking up the next night as well. As in this night, rather. As we are taking over night right now. So, you know, everyone make sure to spend blood that isn't in torpor.
Spend 5 Vita infusion. No, not 5.
This is the night on which you're healing, Alexander, right? You're not acting this night. This is night on which you're healing. You got hurt last night. You need a full night to heal.
Yes, and tonight's the night that John went and fucked up Anton.
No, that was last morning.
Yeah, that was the same day, dude.
Yes, it was the same day. Right after.
All that shit went down on the same day.
I mean, come on, are you gonna wait a night till you deal with a demon worshipper? Fuck no. That shit's dangerous, yo.
I thought there was something off about that.
That's because your time sense is fucked. Anyway, I'm gonna split the video and we will finish this fuckery, hopefully, in a moment.